Nothing too surprising except for eat glass fibers.
The spread is too rapid for any organic bone disease or genetic condition. It's definitely a toxin.
The boy's hyoid bone is broken.
The sternum is snapped transversely from the tip to the xiphoid.
It's like tuberculosis.
I need you to set up the microtome and get me paraffin and an embedding mold.
The BO plateau fractures and ground disturbance suggest total body impact.
You know, I need subtitles walking in here.
What have you found?
X-rays reveal low bone density, and the parathyroid hormone levels are also low. There's a medical condition called hyperparathyroidism.
Symptoms include muscle weakness, brittle bones. Yeah, I know.
Miss Schilling had Well, if I could simplify, a thyroid condition that could weaken her bones.
Maggie's condition didn't respond to medication. I was trying to get her to agree to surgery when she disappeared.
What types of medication are we talking about?
Furosemide, pimidronate, tried various calcitonins.
What about hydromorphone?
There are no pain issues associated with hyperparathyroidism.
Brittle bones from her thyroid condition. The damage could have happened in a very short time.
We also found evidence of inflammation in her right humerus and ilium.
The bone abnormalities indicate pathosis from lying in one position for a long time.
The only reasonable explanation is long-term bondage.
Decreased bone density could have caused the inflammation. This isn't definitive.
You want science? Give me the estimated time of captivity.
Approximately 3 weeks.
Okay, here are your affected areas. Now, during an advanced time simulation,
winning, right? Can I see your findings?
This appears to be indisputable.
The pathogen is coccidioidomycosis.
Valley fever?
It was picked up in the scanner in the discharge vent at Mr. Addy's station.
What's valley fever?
It's a fungus that can lead to pneumonia, meningitis, spontaneous abortion, death.
Coccidioides immitus grows in the soil, producing the infective arthrospores which are disseminated by the wind.
Early symptoms mimic a common cold.
What if it manifests?
The first treatment protocol involves extremely painful injections into the base of the brain.
Laboratory tests are of great value in the diagnosis of coccidioidomycosis. It can be distinguished from other molds by its grayish-white growth, which predominates on this plate, and the development of chains of small barrel-shaped arthrospores.
Is he contagious?
Dr. Hodgins may have inhaled the spores, yes.
Okay, it must suck to be Hodgins right now, but the rest of us, we didn't inhale, so it's okay that I go, right?
Dr. Hodgins may have exhaled the spores all over us.
We have no choice but to impose quarantine. Valley fever can be fatal, and we can't risk a pandemic.
Okay, you know what? If this is fatal, I will shoot both of you.
In summary, the disease coccidioidomycosis is endemic only in certain semi-arid regions of the New World.
Whoa. Bless you. Uh-oh. Is that valley fever? Bones.
When do they insert the needle into your brain?
I sneeze because the air is dry. It's not valley fever.
Any other symptoms? Headache?
Any foul-smelling pustules on your shins?
Green. Green. Is that green as in go, or green as stick a needle in your brain?
Merry Christmas.
Oh.
Yes!
This is interesting.
Interesting or horrible? Because sometimes it's the same thing with you.
This hole in the sternum, it's definitely not a gunshot wound.
It's a sternal foramen.
I found the same exact thing on the female victim's sternum. It seemed like a meaningless anomaly.
It's a hereditary condition. The two victims were related.
Based on their ages, father and daughter.
I don't think he murdered those people.
You can tell if he murdered someone by looking at his x-rays?
He has the same genetic condition the two victims had, the sternal foramen. They're probably his sister and his father. We don't just have a killer on our hands. We have a cannibal. Have you diagnosed anyone recently with a prion disease?
Prion disease? No. Some Alzheimer's, yes. Some brain damage due to alcoholism and huffing.
Delusions? Erratic behavior? Violent outbursts?
The incubation period for a prion disease can be years. You're thinking that the cannibal might be showing symptoms of mental deterioration?
Dr. Rigby, I never said anything about a cannibal.
Well, it's all over town.
I mean, this was a fascinating case. You don't often find ritual cannibalism practiced so close to home.
Which I find a plus.
There are always those individuals within a species who are driven to break the most basic taboos. I mean, Rigby actually ate human flesh.
Bones, I just got my steak and eggs.
Rigby has a prion disease, which means he's been a cannibal for quite some time. Do you realize when we go to trial, he could use the insanity defense?
The guy is nuts.
Yes, but is he nuts because he got a brain disease from eating human flesh? Or was he already nuts the first time he ate flesh? Or did he just lick his fingers after surgery?
I should just become a vegetarian.
Or as an alternative, just don't eat people.
Be kind, rewind.
You know, I need subtitles walking in here.